We're back on the Magic of the Musicals. It's Alex Belfield in a very cold and wintry New York, and we've come to 44th Street and Broadway to the Majestic Theatre to talk to the big star of Phantom of the Opera. And quite frankly, there's only one, and that's the Phantom, and that's Howard McGillen. How are you?
I'm great, Alex. Good to see you.
It's good to see you. And what a life you've got. You're the star of probably the biggest show in the world. It's one of the oldest and one of the most well-known, and you're it. That must be nice.
It is. It's amazing. I mean, I think in some ways it's hard not to take it for granted. I've done it now for over 7 years running. I mean, spanning 9 years actually, because I took a couple years off. But it's phenomenal. It's incredible.
What are you like as a person? Because I've interviewed so many Phantoms over the year, whether it's in the West End, whether it's in Vegas or here, and some are very dark, and then others take it as a joke and as something that you should mock and just enjoy. Are you the kind of person that shuts the curtains all day and just stays dark?
Absolutely not. I mean, when I first took over here at the Majestic, I was warned, it's only a matter of time, and you're going to be... You know, because everyone who's played the Phantom here has changed, you know, and they've become very dark. And I said, look, you know, I mean, one of the advantages of coming to this role at this point in my career, I've been doing this now, I've been working on Broadway for the last 25 years. So I had a perspective on it to begin with. It wasn't do or die, life or death. I it wasn't going to be the end all and be all of my life. So I was so happy to have the opportunity to play it and have enjoyed so much the rewards of doing it this long. But I am perfectly able to leave it at the stage door when the day is done.
Good, you're not going to kind of kidnap me or anything. That's good.
No, that won't be happening.
And let's talk about your career, because you've had such a wonderful career. You've worked both here and the other side at the Atlantic, and you've worked in all the biggest shows. Your highlights, what have you enjoyed the most?
Well, I would have to say probably the highlight in my career was... if not now, because you cannot take away from me this wonderful experience of doing Phantom of the Opera for this long. But that aside, I would have to say Anything Goes was one of the high points of my career. It was just so much fun to do that show. We had a lovely run here. I think I was in it in New York for 20 months or so, and then was lucky enough to be asked to go over and open the show in London with Elaine Page, Bernard Cribbins. We had a blast.
And how does it feel for you going from here, Broadway, to the West End? Because I know our guys dream of coming here.
I have to say that it was always a dream of mine to work in the West End, and was happy to do it, not just with Anything Goes. It's always, always a thrill to work in London.
And to be asked, because there's so many people for them to choose from, and to get Equity to allow you to go over, you've got to be something special, haven't you?
Yeah, and there was a lot of talk about how, I don't know if it's going to be possible. And I was finally, I somehow slipped through, and was so happy to be there.
You're known for your stage presence, and you really need to have it with Phantom. You can't half sell this, can you?
You can't, no. I mean, unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, you can't walk through this. And not that I think I ever would, but it keeps you on your toes. You have to come in, and you have to go at this 100%. You cannot walk through it. It's such an intense character. And by the end of the show, I'm wrung out. I really am just dripping sweat. I mean, first of all, the makeup process alone seals your entire hairline in this bald cap that you put on first before all of the other layers of makeup are put on, several layers of latex and wigs and hats and everything. So, you're really dripping wet by the end of the evening, which is a wonderful and perhaps a little bit disgusting at the same time feeling. But it's a great, great ride to do this show.
And as for the technical side to this show, it is amazing to me that this was created over 20 years ago, and theatre's moved on so much in terms of the production, yet it's still contemporary, it's still big, it's still impressive. I mean, this must have been way beyond its years when it first got on the stage.
It must have been. I remember seeing it. Actually, I was doing Anything Goes at Lincoln Center just a few miles up the road when this show opened, and I remember coming to see it in previews, and it was the most talked about show. We were a little bit jealous, actually, up there, because we had a pretty good show, too. But this was it. You know, this was the show. And I just remember sitting in my seat thinking, wow, this is theatrical spectacle times 10. And then you add in all the other layers, the beautiful music and, of course, the story itself. And it's, you know, here we are 20 years on, almost 21 years on the Broadway stage, and I know it's coming up 22 years in London, and the audiences are still riveted by it. And it's, you know, every once in a while you have to kind of pinch yourself and say, this is amazing. This is unprecedented that a show like this can have this kind of staying power. It's broken, of course, all the records. And I think that's the reason.
And 19 years ago when you sat there, did you ever dream that one day it would be you?
No, never. No. It didn't occur to me at the time. Well, you know, of course, because I had just begun the work on Anything Goes, and Anything Goes was as far a cry from Phantom of the Opera as you could possibly get. You know, it's light and silly and, you know, a farce, and it was a complete lark to be doing that show. And so it just never crossed my mind at the time. But little did I know what I had in store for me, because it's just been, as I said, a blessing.
Is there anything that could beat this in terms of profile or heritage on Broadway?
Well, you're always looking for something new to do. I mean, obviously, the blessing of having done this long has been great. You know, it's been good for the pocketbook, and it's been good for a number of reasons, of course, to be able to have a job to go to every day. But you know, of course, you look for the next job, and I don't really have any particular role that jumps out at me and says I have to do that. But I'm always ready, and while doing this, I'm taking part in workshops of up and coming or hopeful up and coming shows that are in development. So you know, you always keep an eye open. But for the meantime, I'm very happy to have this.
Howard, it's a true thrill to meet you, because you're such a big star and such an impressive performer. I think I've seen you in this twice before over the years, and there's just something menacing about you, but warm at the same time. And it's getting that balance right, isn't it?
I think that's really key to it. And thank you very much for the compliment. I appreciate it. As I said, I felt a definite identification with this character when I first saw it, and certainly subsequently when asked to do it, and I think that's key. And if you the actor can feel that, certainly, hopefully, the audience is going to as well.
And let's face it, they've had enough opportunities to get rid of you if they didn't like you.
That's right. They haven't gotten rid of me yet. So I don't know. I'm doing something right.
Howard McGillin, thank you very much for talking to us on The Magic of the Musicals. Phantom's the big show here at the Majestic on 44th and Broadway. And it is the show to see. It's like an old traditional musical. It's got the scenery, the set, most importantly, the music and the performers. Congratulations to you. Thanks for talking to me.
Thank you, Alex. It's a pleasure.